I feel paralyzed. Hello guys, what's going on? It's Lemon King here, and welcome back to another Minecraft Pixelmon video. And today we're picking up sort of where we left off, and we're gonna go over some things that happened when I was away doing stuff off camera, and then get into the new stuff on the screen. So one new thing that has happened since last time is the house has been completed. Nice little finished up house here, that's all fun dandy. And also these guys have built in over here the life tracks, and there was also someone else working in there. And they also sent me a nice little thank you gift that they sent over for me down here. They sent me some mail, burn heals, super potions, and diamond. So I responded and sent some back, and I also bought some more mail in case I wanted to go around to other new neighbors and send them some greetings from over at my house over on the ocean. So, thanks for the gifts, Lightrex. And we also fought some bosses and got some more stuff, like, you know, Water Pulse, some other awesome things that are up here and stuff. And we also got 2 Moonstones out of it. So one thing you'll notice in my 6th line of Pokemon is Ivysaur was upgraded to the Venusaur level. Now he's level 34, so Venusaur is now in the deck, ready to go. And we also have 2 more guys, Charmeleon, which we're going to work on today in this video, upgrading him to Charizard. And we're also going to throw down Jigglypuff and Nidorina with the Moonstone and get them upgraded. So let's start out with that. Let's throw Jigglypuff out here somewhere. Come on, Jigglypuff. There's little Jigglypuff. Let's drop a Moonstone on him. And Jigglypuff should turn into Wigglytuff. I'm pretty sure that's how it works, Wigglytuff. So evolve Jigglypuff into a greater being. Join the army. So I also did, I did go around and catch some more Pokemon, and I found some more fossils and got them added into the Pokedex. So the Pokedex might be a little different. So now we have a little Wigglytuff here to join us in the adventures. So what does he look like? Okay. Did it register me throwing him out? No. Well, I'm going to need to throw out the Nidorina as well. Or not. I don't know why this happens. It's just like a glitch that happens in the system. I have to go back and try to heal these guys up. Now this could take anywhere from 30 seconds to 50,000 hours. So what's going to happen in this video is, after we finish this Moonstone stuff, because this is obviously going to take forever, is we're going to go and work on getting Charmeleon upgraded to Charizard to toss him off the Pokédex. And other than that, I really don't know what else we're going to have to do here. So we'll just play it by ear. Maybe go catch some more Pokemon or do whatever we want to do, because obviously this is going to take forever. I haven't really looked into going to the gyms yet, because a lot of these gyms, the regular gyms, are you have to have, I think they do 3v3 Pokemon battles, and all the Pokemon have to be level 25 or lower, and some don't accept such attacks. And if you beat them, you get the gym badge and stuff. So we would have to look into doing that eventually, but I want to build us a strong standard team here to work with and work on getting Pokemon through the Pokedex, and then we can go and try to get all the gym battle badges. I'm not entirely sure where Vintage Beef is located on here. He has an island somewhere out there. He's looking to have an island all to himself, and maybe we can go and pay a visit, leave him some mail and stuff, if we can find out where that location is. But I'm not 100% sure where it is, so I can't go out there. So there's no point in going out there and looking for it. This may finish sometime soon. Maybe. Not 100% sure why it's taking so long, but this does this every now and again. It just takes forever to heal a Pokemon. I don't know why. So, maybe this will end in the near future. Almost done. I just gotta wait for them to pop off of the thing and get back into my hands so I can go out there and take Nidorina and turn her into a Nidoqueen. Please, anytime soon will be great, but you know, this game is stupid. The more people that come onto the server is how the lag increases. So, when I joined a little while ago, there was 89 people on, so I'm assuming there's more than 89 people on now, and the more people that are on, the laggier it gets. I was on this morning, and there was only like 50 people at the most on, and it was fine. There wasn't any lag, everything worked as it's supposed to work, but for some reason, once there's more than, you know, 80 people on here, the game decides to freak out and lag it up. Thank you. Now can I take my Nidorina out here? Throw her down. Nidorina send out. Come on, game. This game is so broken. So much lag. Send out Nidorina. I don't know why this is not working. Alright guys, and we are back here. The problem has been solved. And I think what the problem was that there was 100 people on the server and the game was just freaking out. So I left for a little bit and then came back in like an hour. And now the game is running smoothly and we can use the Moonstone on Nidorina and upgrade her to the Nidoqueen. So we have that in the book. So while that's working, I'm going to look up... Well, Nidoqueen should be on my deck because I found Nidorina, so I could find Nidoqueen. And cross her off. And I also need Wigglytuff crossed off, which is also right there. So, perfect. I still don't have a Clefairy or a Clefable yet, either. I could drop Nidoqueen back off because I won't need her anymore. Or Wigglytuff for that matter because they're not that good. So, just Wigglytuff, Nidoqueen, and go back in the bins. I need my Bisharp back. And who else would I really want to use? Tentacruel's good. He's a water type, isn't he? I was using Flygon, but maybe. Water type wouldn't be bad. If I were to take... Tentacruel is the upgraded version, right? What if I were to put the, can I put Water Pulse on Tentacruel? I wonder. Come on out, Tentacruel. Can I put Water Pulse on you? I can! Yeah! He's a psychic. He throws a sturdy wall that raises its defense. I don't need a really a normal move. So we'll put Water Pulse on you. Now you're a pretty darn good Pokemon. Because I have I have Scyther, which is grass and bug, I guess. Pupitar is rock. Bisharp is steel. And we have Tentacruel is water and poison. Venusaur is grass. And if we were to get Charizard and upgrade him, or find another fire type, then we'd have fire in the mix. And then we'd have a pretty darn strong team. Now, another thing that I would go after is either a Ditto, because Ditto is good, because he can turn into any opponent. So if they have a good opponent, I could throw Ditto in, transform, and then zap him out. And then I have him to use. But another good thing would be a Clefable or my Wigglytuff, because they have the sleep, even Snorlax, like the sleep abilities and like Hypnosis and stuff. Those guys could be huge. Hypnosis is good, which Hypno has that. What was the other move I wanted? Like the instant regeneration that Snorlax has and stuff. Yeah, I could use him. I don't know what else to really go for at the moment. We could see how this team turns out. I might find a higher level fire type than Charizard. But Charizard is really cool, and that's why I'm keeping Venusaur in there right now, because Venusaur is good with Petal Dance. What happened down here? This was not here before. I decided to build a road into the ground. Like, what's going on? I thought it was just not loading, but now, unless I have been over here, I don't remember that being there. I really don't. Unless it was, and I'm just, you know. I might just be seeing things. Okay, why am I locking in? So maybe if we could find Beef, I'll go leave a mail message over there for him. Because, you know, say hi, introduce myself, you know, advertisement for the YouTubes and stuff. Just because you can. I don't know how many people are actually going to have the thought process to do that. Because that's the easiest way. Because if you just say, like, I'll say hey Beef when he comes online in the chat and stuff. But he doesn't really respond to that, so. Alright, I just walked in a complete circle and haven't found anything. My Tentacruel is like half dead, more than half dead, so. I need some good things to fight with Charmeleon to get him up to the Charizard. I would still have to go find a Charmander, because I never had a Charmander. I found Charmeleon and upgraded him. So I never had a Charmander to work with. I have to find him. Eevees, I'm going to need a ton of those guys to get with the stones to upgrade into their things. What does this say? You are now entering a Dunsparce safe zone. Stupid Dunsparces. There was a guy out here who had a bunch of stuff like going on. This guy's going to fight. Nice like house out and open here. He had a healer there, so I just ran out here and kept using his healer, and he was like, I don't care. Go ahead. Like, thanks. Dragon Rage is good against these rocks, so that's why I like fighting these gravelers and stuff. I could probably go find different types to battle with, but I've been using Dragon Rage all the time, and it's been working quite well. I don't like fighting these stupid guys because they end up being fire types. So I can only use my... I basically tap into them with my Charmeleon, like hit them once so it gets combat. And then I can swap them out with the 35 duck trio. Then I swap them out to get other better Pokemon that'll take care of the job. Holy crap, Magna 210. Huh, that's unfortunate. Well, Scyther's not taking any of that crap. Scyther's not going to deal with that. Scyther's just going to two-bang in here, almost one-bang. Good job, Scyther. This is the house that I've been in, because he has a Pokemon healer right here. So I just kept running here to do that. So I did. This is it. And then I just go back out here to fight more of these guys. Okay, Charmeleon, you want to try this a second time?
Charmeleon.
I don't know how many levels I actually need to upgrade him. So I don't like fighting these lower level, like 25s, because they're one bangs and it's only 200 HP. I like finding. Numa. I should have pulled out my Charmeleon just to combat attack, so he'll gain XP. So I want to fire up my. Now this is going to be stupid because he's probably going to one bang me now. Oh, okay. It's not one bang. Dragon Rage! Don't kill me. Okay, he's combat tagged. Now let's throw a Venusaur out there. Take care of this new one. Oh, that was a mistake. Why did I think that would work? What was my thought process there? I don't think I had one. Grass type wouldn't be good for that. Okay, he's not very effective against metal, so I'm just gonna use my Metal Claw and destroy him. Okay, this guy is tough. I've had better luck with red bosses, but apparently this Numel is just deadly. Got him. So I got two orbs. I really haven't figured out what I'm supposed to do with these orbs yet. I know you can like turn them into different types of orbs, but I have no idea what they do yet. So, hello, good sir. Oh, now this game is gonna take a slow time. Missed out here using his healer. Dense burst free zone. Okay, no dense bursts here. This is a big Doug trio.
Trio.
Last time I used a Doug trio. Oh, there's all the dense burst. I found them all. That's the only zone here that's not dense burst free. Eh? Found all your dense burst. He's running a secret operation in here. I understand why it's done Spider's free. He goes, captures them all, and throws them into his cage. Why do I have Bisharp out?
Bisharp.
I wanted my... Oh, this is going to suck, because then he's going to get a free shot on Charmeleon. No, he took the hit. Now, he used Magnitude 5. Ooh, yeah, he killed him. Tentacle.
Turn to fool.
There we go. Tentacruel. Tentacruel's actually a good Pokemon. I like him. Get some use out of him. That's what I wanted, like the variety of types here. I don't really have a flying type, do I? Charizard will be the only flying type. Tentacruel's flying-ish, but he should be in water. Scyther flies, kind of. But is he grass bug? I don't know what he technically is. He's something. Bisharp's good with the metal. But there's good variety on this team. So, if only I knew what was powerful against what. Because I'm not the best at figuring that out. Because I'm not... That's why it's called the Noob Saga. Because I'm not the best at Pokemon. I never played, like, a lot of Pokemon as a kid. My neighbors had this Pokemon game that all we did was, like, pick out our random six Pokemon and battle each other. I did pretty good at that. But I really didn't know, like, what type was most effective against what. I just popped out Pokemon and said, okay, I'm using this one. And I was never really informed of what type is good against what. So... Still not really that informative on what type is against what, but able to pull off these battles. You learn as you go, like, this is super effective against this. Okay, maybe I should fight more of these to level up. That's basically what I've been doing. I'm finding all these weird Diglets and Numels I don't really like. Just stupid. You're a big one, but Dunsparces don't get the high up level. What does Dunsparce evolve into? I have no idea. I haven't even heard of a Dunsparce before joining this game. I'm used to all of, like, the first gen Pokemon and second gen Pokemon. That's all that, because this was a Nintendo 64 that we had, that we were playing on. So it was all the old Pokemon. It was like a Pokemon Arena type thing. And it was kind of tense down there. It's Fun time. That's all I wanted to play every time we went down there. We also played Donkey Kong and stuff, but most of the time we ended up playing the Pokemon a lot. So you're a Shinx. I don't know how effective Charmeleon would be against a Luxio or a Luxray and stuff. Not 100% sure. There's a lot of land here that's just like not been built with. There's just holes. Like this is built into the ground, which is a more neat concept. Mine's really just a tower built up into the sky. Maybe if I start walking slower, I can find some Pokemon. This video will end when Charmeleon becomes Charizard. That's when this video ends, so you're stuck with me until that happens. Then I'll go off and do my own thing. I don't know if most of the stuff here is now going to be recorded because I'll be hunting down new Pokemon. And maybe we should go fossil hunting. I know one thing is fossils come in gravel, but I never thought to look at the bottom of the ocean till seeing Beef's video. Because you can go down to the bottom of the ocean where it's all gravel and find fossils. Now, obviously, they're rare, but you can go find fossils in the gravel at the bottom of the ocean without a problem because you don't take damage in this game. There is no taking damage. So, finding fossils would be easy because you wouldn't be able to drown. That's a big Magmar. 46 Magmar. Charmeleon wouldn't do well against the Magmar. There's a floating box. It's the floating box of wonder. Ooh. Wow. A lot of stuff going on over here. It's just like laid out with cobblestone. That's a big hole in the ground. Yeah. Got some big plans, I guess, going on over here. Unless it's all set up for using the plant things, the farms, the breeder thingamajiggers. Those are useful. Okay, come on. There has to be Pokemon here that my Charmeleon could deal with. I'm finding nothing. Should grab. I don't know if there's any more orange wool. There is none. I fried the one thing up. It was all orange wool. I took all the orange wool and turned it into carpet. That's where the carpet of my house came from. I found one and just obliterated it all. I took all the orange, because that's what was left. Well, actually, they dug, I think, one orange out to get down to get the loot. And then I took the rest of the orange and the one blue, I think. I don't even know if the blue was there. Maybe it was. I couldn't tell. I was just focused on the orange. Okay, come on. Where is a Pokemon for me to battle with Charmeleon? This is ridiculous. Of course, the game's like freaking out trying to load stuff in. There's a lot of people online now. There's a lot of people that come online, and there's more and more people coming in for the first time. That's just a sign. Bommy was here. I'd like to be able to find Vintage Beef's Alan, leave him a mail and say, hey, let's go. I watch your videos. I know where you are. Marowak. Fight him. Oh, sure. No. Oh. I don't want him. I want a Charmeleon to do this battle. Ow. That hurt.
Marowak.
Defense was decreased. Okay, just kill this thing. Kill him. Come on, you're almost ready to upgrade. I got two bones out of that. I need to go home and heal him. I don't think there's anything I'm going to be able to kill around here. Because I only have 43 out of my 95 HP. I don't know if there's anything I'm going to be able to kill around here without getting thumped. risk. Why do I keep forgetting to thumb down
Bishop.
To my Charmeleon? I don't want Fish Shark. I want Charmeleon. Honestly, if I could find some of these, I could like put them to sleep. Well, that hurt. It really hurt. I'm gonna get killed here. Yeah. Venusaur. Well, you know, that'll dance him or something. There you go. What's up? I just wanted to get my Charmeleon upgraded to a Charizard because that's all I want in my life right now. Geodude. Actually, Geodudes aren't that high level. That's the problem. Is there anything here? Marowak.
Char.
He's gonna get the first attack though, because he's all high level Marowak. Oh, wait, I can put some damage on.
Marowak.
Ow. He attacked three times, so that explains some things. Pursuit. Doesn't do much damage. Isn't that effective? Keep. Now I gotta run back in here. Heal up again. Why am I missing one Pokeball on that thing? Thank you. It's like, why is there... I'm missing one Pokeball. I want them all healed. Level 40 Marowak. Okay. We challenge you. Go back. The game decides to throw out my Pokeball. Thank you. I don't know if Fire is good against them. I know Dragon is pretty good. That's why I've been using Dragon Rage the whole time. Come on, man. He keeps dying.
Turn to cruel.
I'm not getting any XP because he keeps dying. It's ridiculous. Why is one Pokeball just like stubborn? My Venusaur is just like, nope, not going there. This shouldn't be that complicated. Drapion. I really want to catch him. Because I don't have a Drapion. And Drapion will be a good addition to this family as well. He's attacking me. Just keep running there and using his pokey thing. Thank the Lord it happened. Please just evolve into this Charizard. Well, this guy's evolving. I want to thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you all did, please remember to leave a like. It would be greatly appreciated. Comment down below any ideas you have for future episodes of Pixelmon. And other than that, hope you guys enjoyed. I am going to go and try to catch this Drapion. And yeah, that's about it. So thanks for watching, guys. And I'll see you next time. Are you coming back to my life after all we said and done?